The Infinity starting lineup for Washington. Conroy's the point. Robinson can do everything. 5 feet, 8 inches tall, averages 16 per game. Simmons is the three shooter. Jensen is the power inside, and Jones the defender. And there is Lorenzo Romar. He has won 50 games with Washington, building a power here in the Northwest, has a marvelous recruiting team that's coming in next year as well. But he's concerned only about this year, and now he's concerned about Marcus's American Century game plan.
All right, Steve, for Arizona State, mix up your defenses. Teams have had success against the Huskies doing just that. Give Ike Diago a little support for UW. Shot distribution, that means Will Conroy's got to keep everybody happy. But most importantly, ball pressure on defense to keep Arizona State out of their comfort zones, keep the basketball away from Ike Diago as much as possible.
These guys will be jumping up and down throughout the night. A sold-out crowd here at Bank of America. Everybody dressed in purple, except the home team's in white tonight, and Arizona State in the maroon. Washington gets it to Nate Robinson, who will be defended by Jason Braxton as ASU comes out in the man defense.
Great man-to-man ASU. That's a tough matchup for Nate Robinson. Braxton, 6'3", long, just as quick, athletic. Should be able to keep Nate Robinson in front of him, make him shoot the jumper over the top.
And Gunu picks up his first personal foul, and there's Washington State with a 1-point lead. 2.5 minutes left in overtime. The number 9 team in the nation, Arizona, already beaten by the Cougars at home this year, struggling on the road. And right now, Washington State by 1.
That's what happens when you put the best coach in the country at what has been perennially the worst team in the Pac-10. You start getting upset. You start getting competitive.
Simmons, he hit his final 3 shots against Washington State. They hope things are turning around for Trey. He's been in a little bit of a slump the last couple of weeks.
Always good to knock down that first shot, but we talked about the ball pressure. Washington is on it right now, and they play physically on the perimeter as aggressively as any team in the country. They really do a great job of banging you down with the low body. And
here we go with Nate Robinson with the steal, and it's the second foul on Serge Angunu.
It's 2-1 Angunu. He's got to come out of the game. But we talked about Trey Simmons and his shooting woes over the last couple of weeks. Right here, gets himself off on a nice start. Little fade off the screen from Jensen. Knocks it down from the corner. That's a nice way for Trey Simmons to get started tonight.
So it'll be Washington basketball. Conroy, Robinson in the backcourt. Jensen is their lone low post threat, but he's really a face it up and shoot guy. Simmons back to back shots. He's now hit 5 straight, the last 3 against Washington State, and the first 2 tonight against ASU.
Back to back on that Yakka. Trey Simmons on the fade screen off of Mike Jensen on the elbow. Nice job executing the offensive play.
6-0 Huskies, but a personal foul will be called against Washington.
And there's a little screen by Jensen. There's Trey. I mean, Bryson Krueger was in the key. He got beat so badly on that play, that backdoor setup move by Trey Simmons.
Well, Arizona State does not want to have happen what happened here last year when they lost badly to Washington and they were down 12-0 early in the game and had no chance to come back.
Again, great ball pressure makes it awful tough for the entry into Diago.
Alan Morrell, who came in for Serge Duke and Gunu, who picked up 2 quick fouls, banks in his first shot.
So Morrell against Oregon, he played a very solid game, does a great job feeding the ball. Uh-oh, speaking of solid.
Back to back of tobacco Yakas.
That's Trey for Trey.
Without the Y. And here we go, and a foul will be called, and it's an offensive foul on Braxton, and Rob Evans is furious.
We talked about the aggressiveness that the Huskies approach their man-to-man pressure defense. They get into your body. They make pest nuisances of themselves. Bobby Jones, the biggest nuisance out there defensively, right there. He's just gonna step in right into range of that elbow that just sweeped through by Braxton. He gave up the jaw.
Well, they really want Simmons involved. He has taken 5 shots and made 3. The rest of the team hasn't even taken a shot yet.
That's the thing about this Husky team. They ride the hot hand. They're very unselfish in that regard. If you got it going on, they will get you the basketball.
Ike Diago, double, triple team. He finds his man, Braxton, who cut to the hoop. And that's what Diago can bring.
Yeah, nice job Braxton making that cut, Diago with the feet, but defensively you got to be aware of that. That's the only thing that hurts you.
Diago swats it away, collected Conroy in the corner. Bobby Jones, three. He only hit one last year, and Jones already has 15 this season.
Rob Evans is close to getting teed up here on the sidelines. He wanted an offensive foul despite the block by Diago. And he is livid. He's not even a part of the huddle. He's out there jawing, having a fit. But here's Bobby Jones. That was after that block by Diago. Wide open jump shot in the corner. Forces the Sun Devils into a timeout. But Bobby Jones can give you that on occasion.
Well, if they keep shooting like that, there's no way Arizona State will be able to handle them. They're 3 for 3 from 3-point range. Well, our Pac-10 player of the week comes from the state of Arizona. How about Salim Stoudemire, who had 9 3-pointers in a sweep last week. 9-1 game against Oregon State, a Wildcat school record, and they've had some pretty good shooters in the past.
Some excellent shooters. You're talking about guys like Steve Kerr. I think Jason Gardner is actually the guy whose record that he broke it. But our U.S. Bank Pac-10 player of the week, and he's probably been our U.S. Bank Pac-10 player of the year so far. And I say year, I mean since January 1st, nobody playing better almost in the entire country than Salim Stoudemire.
Well, he's been tested tonight. As last time we checked, Washington State had a 1-point lead over Arizona in overtime. 2 minutes to go.
Nice adjustment by Arizona State. Diago, you know he's going to get double teamed that time mid post. You've got to have cutters flashing aggressively to the basket. You can get some easy looks. They've gotten a couple for Jason Braxton.
Both times, Diago was the feeder. Robinson. Well, the outside defense isn't real good right now for ASU.
Perimeter defense almost non-existent. There's so much sloughing off, sagging going on. You think Washington had a Diago in the post.
Braxton, though, is getting free, and Jason Braxton doesn't give you that much offensively. He's only averaging 5.5 points per game. He's already over that with 6.
He's erupted for 6 big ones out here today.
Jones inside.
Terrible. Now, this is a time I talk about keep him guessing. I mean, this may be a time for Rob Evans to think about mixing up his defenses, because that man-to-man that's being out there tonight is being exposed. It's not affecting whatsoever against Washington.
Braxton's got 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second to finally get it across the timeline, and he does. Kevin Kruger being denied by Conroy. Diago inside, powers it up. No, but he'll be at the free throw line for 2 shots.
And that's Trey Simmons, a little slow, rotating from the bottom side against Diago. As a matter of fact, he was not slow. He was there, but he tried to go for a steal. The gamble got himself out of position. A lot better served just to go up straight and strong and try and body Ike Diago out away from the floor.
See the 205 free throws made? That's 9 more than the entire Washington State Cougar basketball team. He leads the nation in made and attempts.
And the ironic part about that is that the last time these teams played, he had 1 free throw attempt the entire game, and he missed that one. He was just 0 for 1 the first meeting between these two teams. So that meant that Washington did a nice job of not only playing him aggressively, but not overdoing it and committing a lot of cheap fouls.
Arizona State lost that game 79-70, but the real problem they had was turning it over. They had 10 more turnovers than the Huskies. Dan O'Dowd, their fine assistant coach, said that would be concern number one, handling the basketball. Jones backing his way in on Morrell, and we have a whistle. A held ball situation. It'll be Arizona State basketball on the fine defense by that man, Alan Morrell. Right now, Huskies up by 6 over the Sun Devils. We welcome our fans on FSN to Bank of America Arena in Seattle, Washington. It's the Washington Huskies and the Arizona State Sun Devils. Steve Fisiak, Marcus Johnson with you. Washington erupting early. Trey Simmons hitting three 3-point shots. And that's a big reason they right now have a 4-point lead, as Morrell coming in off the bench for Sergen Gounou, who has 2 fouls and has gone to the sideline. Meantime, Nate Robinson, one of the stars for Washington, on the sideline also with 2 personal fouls.
You see Arizona State making the adjustment, picking up Trey Simmons, the ball handler, up full court.
Will Conroy, 4 for 4 from 3-point range. Kevin Kruger, that is his game. He's one of the best in the conference at 3-shooter and pulls ASU to within 4.
Doing a nice job just letting the game come with him and forcing it into Diago. He's not had a field goal attempt thus far.
Diago with a rebound. ASU splits the wings out to give room for Diago, who goes down to the middle, posting up. Hakeem Rollins in the game will defend Diago. So hot coming off the bench, misses his first. And the rebound goes to Brandon Roy, who comes into the game. And he might be the Huskies' best player as their sixth man.
Again, the defense of Arizona State. That's been the problem for them offensively. They're playing sharp. But defensively, right there, Brandon Roy, nobody stops the basketball. He's allowed to make a spin move and get about 2 feet from the cup.
And it's been their problem all year long. They are 9th in points allowed this year in the conference and 9th in field goal percentage against. Opponents shooting almost 48% from the floor against them. Braxton swings it to Moore. And Moore is fouled.
Talk about Brandon Roy. I mean, somebody's got to stop basketball when it gets around the free throw line. No one does that. He spins off the contact of Morrell inside. And then here's Roy kicking it to Will Conroy. Garfield to Garfield. A couple of Garfield High School dogs here in Seattle getting it done at the Bank of America Arena.
And that was the second foul against Jamal Williams. So 2 for Williams, 2 for Nate Robinson, and the Huskies have some foul difficulty in the first 6.5 minutes of this ball game.
Wherever we go, fouls just seem to follow us around, don't they?
We had that game in Oregon with the Huskies. What, 85 fouls called?
We're just foul magnets. We were down in Tucson when Arizona shot 40 free throws, made 38 against these very same Huskies.
That's right.
Just want to impress us by blowing those whistles. Must think we're cooling the game with somebody.
Well, maybe we should tell them the officials are Bill Kennedy, Tim Gavitaro, and Kevin Brill.
Cooling the game concert. He's up on the whistles.
20-15, Washington. Lorenzo Romar pacing the sideline, a little concerned because his star Nate Robinson picked up 2 quick fouls and only played 3 minutes.
Lorenzo said, "I have seen this before." Down in Eugene a few days back.
Well, I will say this about Romar. In that game, so many fouls called. He did a great job holding his poise and never got a technical foul. I think he's only gotten 4 in his career.
Trying to go work inside Jamal Williams. A great back to the basket post up guy against the freshman Pierce, which is in his office. Close the deal.
Diago rebounds the miss. Sun Devils close to within 1 bucket. Jackson misses. Diago does not. Jim Pierce, excuse me, does not. Pierce picks up his first field goal, and it is the Sun Devils within 2.
And some of this depth from Arizona State really starting to play some pretty good basketball. Pierce, Jackson, talked about Morrell.
Welcome again to Bank of America Arena in Seattle, Washington. The Huskies, the number 14 team in the nation, have a 4-point lead on Arizona State. Steve Fisiak, Marcus Johnson with you. Brandon Roy just on an alley-oop dunk for his second field goal of the game. Kevin Kruger, short jump shot, in and out. And Pierce trying to chase it down in the corner. And there's Brandon Roy saying, it's got to be Husky basketball.
I tell you, Arizona State could just tighten up a little on defense right here. Too easy on the backdoor lob. That's Jackson just totally out of position. No contact with this offensive guy going back door. That's a no-no. But a good job of executing by the University of Washington.
And our guy we highlighted threw him the pass. Yeah. Will Conroy with his fourth assist. He leads the Pac-10 in assists at 6.5 per game. When the season began, Will Conroy said that was his goal. He wanted to lead the conference in assists.
And he is doing just that. And when you have as many terrific offensive weapons as you do, I mean, it's just a question of finding guys in the right position.
Morrell with the charge.
There's that ball pressure. Now, Alan Morrell talked about him, a nice post feeder, especially in their high-low game. It's high-low inside of Diago. But Bobby Jones doing a great job of just harassing, arms active. And then when Morrell tries to put it on the floor, which is the weakness of his game, that far from the basket, Bobby Jones right there for the offensive foul.
And that's the second time that Bobby Jones has accepted the charging foul.
Took the elbow from Braxton early on this time, gave it up to Alan Morrell, a guy who the Sun Devil players all say is the strongest man in their team and maybe in the Pac-10.
Nate Robinson back in the game with two fouls.
He's got to be smart there under control. Pick up the keeper.
Jones missing Diago with another rebound. Right? Diago leads the conference in rebounding with almost 10 per game. That was his third.
Still no field goal attempts by Diago. It's time to ride the horse, ride the big horse, saddle him up.
Sometimes you gotta let the big dog eat.
Yep.
Stevie Moore misses both his shots. Morrell. No. Brandon Roy, the middle by Mike Jensen. He will miss the shot. Offensive foul against Jensen.
I questioned that one. It looked like there was some movement on the part of the defender underneath the basket. He did give up the body, but I thought he was kind of hedging his body.
Well, Will Conroy has four assists already in the game. Here's one to Brandon Roy. Washington with a 22-18 lead on Arizona State.
The Huskies better handle their business, much like the Wildcats of Arizona handled their business down in Pullman this evening, just barely in overtime, but they did what they were supposed to do. You can't look past this Arizona State team.
Roy got bumped as he was going in the air, and let's see who the personal foul call goes against. Jason Braxton, that is the personal foul, so Kruger will come back in for Braxton.
And that's two fouls on Jason Braxton.
And the inbounds to Brandon Roy.
Kruger snoozing out there. You know, you're playing against a very athletic Brandon Roy. You've got to put some body on him. Be aware of that quick lob from underneath. He wasn't. He gets burned.
Robinson almost got the steal, and then it looked like Kevin Kruger stumbled and goes over and back to Robinson's defense, paying off despite the two fouls.
Right in here, you're going to see all this action in here. There's Kruger kind of snoozing, not paying attention. All of a sudden, out of bounds, and inbounds, just throws it up there near the rim. And, you know, Brandon Roy can do that, go and get it. And talk about the physical defensive pressure of Washington. You saw it right there as Kruger gets bumped and that falls down, gets the violation. Uh-oh.
Looked like Nate Robinson stepped on the baseline. Ooh, nice little flip over his shoulder and it went in the basket. Right now the Huskies with a 6-point lead, 10:37 remaining. Arizona State continues their push to the NCAA tournament. They have 18 wins with 3 to go at Washington, Washington State, and then home to Arizona.
And they need to get one of those next 3. I mean, it's going to be a tough one here, but they're right there where they want to be. Washington State not any easier down in Pullman, even though they've had some success against them.
Diago misses the shot but is fouled, and it may be against Bobby Jones. It is, and it's Jones's first. Now for ASU, they've had some big wins this year, but they've also had two tough losses to USC.
USC at home and away, obviously. Cal at home, that's a bad loss. We talked about the remaining three. I mean, you know, they get 19 wins, they win one of the next three. And that's, you know, that's not a gimme going up to Pullman against Washington State, even though you could expect them to maybe be a little, have a little bit of a letdown after that tough game against Arizona tonight. That gives them 19. They win one of the Pac-10 tournament. 20 wins, is that enough, even though your Pac-10 record may be, what, 8-10 for the season or whatever it's going to turn out to be? That's going to be an interesting question for the selection committee.
And Rob Evans has to be proud of the team because they're picked to finish last in preseason. Seven wins is the most by a team picked last since 1988-89 Oregon State team that won seven games.
It's been a surprising Pac-10 season. A lot of teams at Oregon, for example, was picked to finish in the top three or four in the Pac-10. They've struggled.
Diago with another rebound, his fourth.
State, you have to be feeling pretty good. You're 4 points down here, and Ike Diago has done absolutely nothing offensively. But you can't continue to cast up those long, quick jumpers and not look at him. At least give him a look down in the post.
Conroy misses the pull-up. Diago with the rebound. Outlet ahead to Tyrone Jackson as they go with Morrell. Diago, Jackson, Kruger, and Stevie Moore. Moore's been very quiet, and a whistle. Timeout. Arizona State. It comes with 9 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the first half, and the Sun Devils only trailing number 14 Washington by 4 points.
I think Rob Evans looked up and saw that 2-3 zone, wanted to talk about it a little bit, how they're going to attack it.
Well, this week, ACC Sunday Night Hoops returns when number 2 ranked North Carolina battles Maryland in a showdown between national championship contenders. Coverage begins with our tip-off show Sunday at 5 o'clock Eastern, 2 o'clock Pacific, only on FSN. North Carolina, Washington, Arizona have been battling all year long for the scoring championship in the nation. North Carolina, over 90 points per game. They lead the country.
Yeah, another very deep, exciting, talented team. Raymond Felton, one of the better point guards. Rashad McCants, an athletically talented two guards. Sean May doing a great job inside. And then a local kid from the Seattle area, Marvin Williams, a freshman coming off the bench, spelling Jawad Williams. But he's having himself quite a year also.
Seattle's a hotbed. Here is Moore trying to go inside, stolen by Nate Robinson.
Once again, the Huskies do the great game tackling defensive job on Ike Diago inside.
Kruger picks up the loose basketball. Outlet to Diago. He's got Jones on one side. He's finished. And Tim Gabbatera, the official, said it was a great pin by Bobby Jones. Held ball. Washington basketball.
That is an exceptional defensive play. You talk about anticipation. There's a spin. Come back here, big fella. Got that. All ball. And Bobby Jones maybe not looking like it, but the strip to fling big, strong Ike Diago to the floor gets the possession back for his team.
Arizona State now staying in the man defense, and a steal. And Arizona State with a two of Washington.
And again, you know, Ike Diago has no field goal attempts. All his points so far in this game from the free throw line. Just got that one block, so that's one. He's pretty much giving you nothing out there in the dunk, too. Feeling pretty good.
Mike Jensen misses the three. A whistle and another foul called. This time against Washington.
Entire ASU team standing up in encouragement. They're feeling pretty good. Their confidence is flowing right now. And Alan Morrell gives them a reason for that with that nice job of anticipating the pass, flooding the passing lane, and getting the easy dunk at the other end.
Simmons, meantime, picking up the foul. But Alan Morrell hasn't played much this year. The 6'7 junior from Arlington, Texas. Averaging 2.5 points per game, but we've seen more time in the last couple of weeks.
Playing behind Serge Anguna, who's played well the last 12 games, so that 10 points, 8 rebounds during that stretch. Serge struggled against Oregon, just 1 for 8 from the field. And it was Alan Morrell's play last 10, 12 minutes of that game that was a big key. And again, not scoring points, but plays like that, rebounding, steals, and more importantly, his post feeds inside the Ike Diago key.
Sun Devils already with 10 free throw attempts. Washington mainly has been doing their damage outside, so we've got a new ball game at 24 all.
Tyler Jackson kept Aaron Brooks in front of him when they played against Oregon. Now he's got Nate Robinson, another challenge, but he's got the defensive skills to do it.
Jensen trying to set a screen for Nate. Swing it around to Simmons. Simmons can't hit past Diago and the rebound Morrell.
So Simmons went inside because he looked tougher and stronger than that expected to get hit. Uh-oh.
And that is Diago's first field goal of the game, and it's Arizona State's first lead of the game.
Comes just under the 8-minute mark, and once again gambling. Mike Jensen going for the steal. Gets himself out of position. Allows the lane to the hoop for Diago. You can't do that. Or if you do it, you better come up with the basketball.
Did they call an illegal screen on Mike Jensen?
Yep. Will Kennedy got him for the moving screen out top.
Time out of the floor, 7:34 left, first half. Sun Devils 26, Huskies 24. Arizona State has to be feeling pretty good, leading by two with Diago only making one field goal. Well, speaking of Ike, our Chevrolet trivia question has Diago leading the Pac-10 with scoring and rebounding. Who is the last Pac-10 player to finish the season leading both categories? We'll give you the answer later in the game.
Well, I'm the last one that I remember, but it's got to be somebody since then, because that was back in the 30s.
It's always about you, Marcus. Always about you. I never had the opportunity to pass you the basketball.
Tonight it's about Ike Diago and the defense that's been played on him, and the fact that his Arizona State team is still playing exceptional basketball without his offensive contributions.
That's the guy they need. Stevie Moore's been terrific last four games, averaging almost 19 per game. Someone to stretch the defense away from Diago.
And Steve Moore did a great job against Oregon, 22 points, and yeah, there were some threes mixed in there, but also did a nice job with the mid-range game, which has been missing from his arsenal this season.
Conroy with the pull-up and gets it to roll.
And so that's what we talked about at the beginning of the game and the open. The Will Conroy, 9.5 points a game, mainly the assist guy, but when he sees things kind of bogging down offensively, he's got the skills to make those little in-between floaters.
Sun Devils bench out playing the Huskies bench,
which is a surprise because the Huskies bench, Jamal Williams, Randy Woods, have come up big for this team all season long.
Pierce loses the ball. Conroy fighting for it. Arrow says Sun Devils basketball with ASU leading by three.
But they're going to move the basketball. There's the draw right there. One pass, and then going to see another pass in the corner to Steve Moore. We don't see him yet, but that's making the extra pass. You see a stumble by Bobby Jones defensively. That's all the time that Steve Moore needs to deliver the jumper.
Kruger looking for the catch and shoot. Now pulls back, and they'll take the shot. The dribble missed back to the iron. No. And on his back, the Huskies fighting for it and lose it and turn it over.
That's Alan Morrell inside, the big guy, the big hoss in there creating space, bumping bodies around, knocked Bobby Jones a little off balance as he tried to secure that defensive rebound.
Morrell really throwing guys around early in this game. He was wide open underneath and Moore couldn't find him. Those guys, when you read their bios, it says track and field, baseball, football, basketball. His said basketball and boxing.
Dangerous combination, but there's an easy shot missed inside. Rob Evans really working these officials out here. Roger Romar taking the opposite tack, going to the very end of the bench. Kind of chilling, cool, not really saying a whole lot.
Moore defended by Robinson. Misses the three. Diago with the.
That's what I love about Ike Diago, the way he battles inside for the offensive rebounds, but then he's got the explosion to come down with that quick second bounce to just get up and in the cup.
Good steal by Braxton, but Robinson gets it right back and pulls up and nails the three.
That's what, like a 5-point swing right there. You save an easy two on the dunk. Possible breakaway by Braxton, and you come back down and bury a three for your team.
Washington in the zone. Two guys out top, Simmons and Robinson. Diago takes a look. And they say it was last touched by the Sun Devils.
And then there's Nate Robinson. He got his pocket pick. He picks the pocket back of Jason Braxton. And then Morrow just a little too slow closing out on the perimeter. And then we talked about the big fella inside. Little pump fake. And then just the explosion up and in. See a lot of guys his size, 6'7", 6'8", with the ability with somebody hanging on your back to jump in the cup like that.
Robinson again for three.
He's on. His own. Nate came out here about 5:15. I got here. He was already sweating, shooting three-pointer after three-pointer, working on that long jump shot.
Well, Nate Robinson didn't play much early because of the two personal fouls, but back-to-back he goes last 30 seconds for a quick outside.
This is what he was doing at the start of the season when he was MVP in the Great Alaska Shootout. He was knocking down the long ball, and he's really put in a lot of work, particularly today, working on that shot.
And his father was a great basketball football star at the University of Washington. 1982 Rose Bowl MVP and the 85 Orange Bowl MVP, the only athlete ever to do that. Great running back here for the Huskies.
I like to be the diamond in the stud in his earrings. I can hear that conversation.
Well, there's a guy who would like to have a young Jacques Robinson.
Yeah.
He's just look at him. He is such a gentleman. Tyrone Willingham. He got an old friend, Bobby Simmons, to come in and run his special teams, who was also an outstanding recruiter. But we'd love to see the University of Washington football program get back to the prominence we saw for so many seasons. Great coach.
Yeah, just a couple of great character guys between Coach Willingham and Coach Romar. They're getting much better than that. Washington staying in that 2-3 zone defense, mainly to neutralize Diago, kind of goad him to step out of the perimeter, start shooting jump shots, take his presence away from the offensive glass.
Is that zone trying to make it
difficult?
Moore cuts through, gets fouled. Boy, the officials really are taking control of this game.
And that's great offense. Nice job. The execution, getting it inside to Morrell, who kind of swings around. He knows that Stevie Moore is coming. Right here, Morrell's got the basketball, but he knows that Stevie Moore is coming. And almost a blind pass. As soon as he turns, he delivers. Moore gets fouled, gets himself to the free throw line. That's a design play by Rob Evans to attack the 2-3 zone in Washington.
Arizona State 9 of 11. That's what's keeping them in this ball game, as Washington has not even attempted a foul shot tonight.
And that does sound surprising when you think about Washington. They have been more perimeter oriented in this game. And it worked well for them the first 2 or 3 minutes when those shots were falling, but now they've cooled a bit.
They do have a low block score now in the game, and Jamal Williams, he gets most of his work done in the paint.
Got to go to him.
No, go to Nate. He misses the shot, gets fouled by Tyrone Jackson. So Robinson will be at the free throw line for the first three foul opportunities for the Huskies tonight.
Just bad defense by Tyrone Jackson. He recognizes there's a little flare screen right there that Nate Robinson's going to use to drift corner, and didn't get him on the shot, but got him with the body after the shot was delivered. It's a bailout foul by Tyrone Jackson.
Nate Robinson. Drops the first foul shot. He's a junior. And he could be the most exciting player in college basketball with his explosiveness and quickness and strength. A guy who's only 5'8" tall.
Could be the most exciting player in college football, too, if he were to go that route. Rugby, ping pong, video games.
He played football here for the Huskies his freshman year and started at cornerback, even had an interception in a bowl game.
Yep. It always amazes me how you know, Tony Gonzalez's and guys on that level who are able to just excel like those two different sports.
It's not fair.
Deion Sanders, Bo Jackson's.
Marcus Johnson. Academics and athletics. And good looking. You make me sick.
Basketball and talking. Two, three zone, awful cut. Again, you got Diago way out on the perimeter. Now they're starting to run. I'm going to look to him a little bit, I would think.
Great job by Nate Robinson leading that transition. He saw he had a rebound. Hakeem Rollins in position. That's when he pulled up, found the glass.
13 for Robinson. Krueger nails the three. Was knocked down, but no foul called.
Robinson lucky to avert his, would have been his third personal foul here in the first half.
And Rob Evans with his hands to the heavens saying, hey, my guy got mugged. How come Robinson went to the free throw line? It's Conroy cutting by, and Robinson with the assist.
The Seattle connection. Rainier Beach High School, Nate Robinson to Garfield High School, Will Conroy. Bad defense, Kevin Krueger. Relax once again.
Diago misses long. He's now taken six shots, made two. Conroy loses it out of bounds as he was fighting for the offensive rebound. There's a timeout on the floor, 2 minutes and 27 seconds remaining in the first half. Huskies on a mini run here have opened up a 39-35 lead on Arizona State. Washington with a 39-35 lead over Arizona State. 2:27 to play. Huskies working Mr. Robinson.
Doing a great job of it also. Right there, a couple of dribbles going left, knocks that down, and then give me that back, and nobody's going to close out. Okay. Got the high from long range, and then once again, a little flare screen. Defense slow reacting. Nate Robinson, 4-for-4 from the field. All three of his free throws, 13 points, 11 of those the last 4 minutes of this game. That's the kind of explosive score that he can give you out there on the floor.
And they would love to see it this time of the year, because he has those streaks where he can be absolutely incredible. Sun Devils throw it away. That cost them in game one. They had 10 more turnovers than Washington and lost by 9.
And, you know, two or three of those turnovers, like Diago just uncharacteristically bobbles the ball out of bounds, not being able to secure it. That pass, I thought, led him a little too much to the baseline, but he's got such terrific hands. I've seen him pull passes like that in and score. Offensive foul on the screen, Hakeem Rollins. This game is, the physicality level of this game is amping up as we speak.
And Conroy hit the three, no basket because the foul prior to. So Arizona State down by 4 is a chance to get a little closer at the 2 minute mark. Wallace is second.
I think they look to go maybe a little high and low. You got kind of a 4 out, 1 in. I like the average work in the low box area. And look inside to him with the pressure, that ball pressure out top. Keeps it from getting the time look inside.
Away by Rollins. It's his third block of the game. Rollins had 2 on 1 possession.
I mean, the game plan is to go in the Ike, but because of the pressure, the ball pressure out top by the Husky perimeter people, it makes it awful tough to get a clean look, even if Diago's open inside.
Diago trying to feed more off the hand. That's a 9th turnover against Arizona State. Roy in. No. Brandon gets his own rebound, swings it back outside with a new clock.
He took that one away from Mike Diago and Alan Morrell, two of the stronger players on this Arizona State team.
And Jones nails the three-pointer. And Washington staying in this game, extending the lead 7-for-10 from three-point range.
Keeping up the pressure. Double in the backcourt.
Kruger had an opening, but turned the shot off to the left wing, and it's knocked out of bounds.
Right here, you're gonna see it. The defenders get sagged inside. They're gonna leave Bobby Jones wide open. He knocks it down.
Kruger comes right back to drain a three from the left corner. The Sun Devils within four again.
Bad transition defense. The passing was nice, but the transition defense left a lot to be desired. You had three guys just getting across midcourt, and Rob Evans is letting those three players, like Diago being one of them, know about their lax effort. You see Diago pointing, somebody get my guy. Nobody picks up Bobby Jones inside. And the first thing you got to do defensively if you're in transition D is protect the basket, protect the painted area first.
And Jones having another one of those quiet games where you look down, you go, Bobby Jones has 10 points?
We saw him against Oregon. He had some question as to how much he was going to play because he was ill. Had 16 points. I think he was pretty much perfect from the field in that game.
You know, he's one of those guys that wouldn't wow you if you're going to scout him. All he does is help you win.
Yep.
Conroy on Kruger. Looks like ASU wants to go for the final shot or make it life difficult for Washington to take it. Jackson, Kruger, Morrell, Diago, and Stevie Moore.
And with their pressure, the Huskies even make the prospects of taking the final shot of the half a tough, tough chore outside.
There's Stevie Moore. That's the guy you want. And Moore nails the three with 5 seconds left. Conroy fumbles it out of bounds, and it will be Arizona State basketball with 0.2 seconds left. But they got it to the right guy, Stevie Moore, outside for a three-point shot to pull ASU within three.
The smart defense on the part of Tyrone Jackson gets in the path of Will Conroy, forces him to bobble the basketball just enough, waste some more time off the clock.
It hit off the back of the iron, but it would not have counted had it fallen. Ike Diago held down just 6 shots. He made 2 in the first half, but Stevie Moore's 3 with 6 seconds remaining in the first half cut it to 3 at the break. Washington Huskies have a 44-41 lead on Arizona State. Steve Fiziak again with Marcus Johnson. The Huskies have so many weapons. Sometimes Trey Simmons, other times it might be Bobby Jones or Will Conroy. Well, Nate Robinson in that first half was the guy who was making the plays.
Yeah, did a nice job. And Nate, his last 2 games combined, just 15 total points. Tonight he's really been aggressive offensively. Right here gets the steal back from Jason Braxton. They don't close out on the perimeter. He makes a pay. And, you know, when Nate's got that outside shot falling, his confidence really, really soars at the offensive end. You see the little bank right there, the kind of afterthought bank shot. And Nate's been a big key. Now for Arizona State, Ike Diago is getting a lot of defensive attention, so there's a lot of jump shots to be had out there. And Steve Moore is doing a nice job capitalizing on that. And Kevin Kruger also is going to get himself some open looks because of the defensive attention shown to Ike Diago.
The AMPM stats, you see how Arizona State's doing their damage inside while Washington is doing their damage outside, hitting 7 3-pointers in that first half. But if you're Rob Evans, are you concerned or are you happy that you're within 3 and Diago's only 2 for 6?
I think you're ecstatic. I mean, you're elated that Ike Diago has struggled a bit offensively and you're still right there because you've got contributions from your other guys. Now, the second half is a time to go into Ike Diago, getting more involved, getting more active offensively, and let the true Ike Diago show his colors here in the second half.
How about Washington? They're 7 of 10 from 3-point range, and yet they only lead by 3. They may have to pound it inside a little bit more in the second half. We'll be right back. The University of Washington loves to play here at Bank of America Arena. They're the only unbeaten team at home in the Pac-10 Conference at 13 wins, no losses. Our AM/PM leading scorers, Stevie Moore had 9, including 2 3-pointers. Kevin Kruger, 3 of 4 from three-point range. Diago held the 7 in the first half. He averages 22. Nate Robinson, he had a stretch where he scored 11 of his 13 in a 4-minute period. Jones with 10. Simmons with 8. All 8 were in the first 3 minutes of the game. So here we go. Second half. Washington basketball. Huskies by 3, going with Conroy Robinson backcourt. Jensen, Simmons, Jones front line. And Robinson misses his first shot, and that's the first miss of the game for Nate. Jason Braxton back in the game playing with 2 fouls. Serge Anguna back in playing with 2 fouls. Moore, Diago, and Kevin Kruger.
Stevie Moore played so well in that first half. He got himself the starting nod here to start the second half. I thought they were very effective. Arizona State with Alan Morrell on the floor also, even though Serge Anguna is going to get the start here in the second half.
Simmons lost the ball and now watched it come out. It seems like he banged his right leg, and they're trying to get him out of the game. Bill Kennedy, lead official, will hold the game up for Brandon Roy to come in, and Simmons will limp off the floor. He dove for the basketball and jammed his left side along the baseline as he rolled out of bounds with the ball. ASU will have 13 seconds left in the shot clock. So Trey Simmons, best 3 shooter on the team, is out of the game. Now a foul will be called, and I believe it's going to go against Will Conroy, who's fighting through a screen.
That's Will's complaint.
And here's some scores. We told you about the overtime game in Pullman. Arizona wins over Washington State. Stanford being beaten by 10 points against Oregon State. And there is Oregon up on Cal by 8 at the half, and UCLA by 16. That's an awfully important game for the Bruins. They have 14 wins overall and 8 in conference play. 15-9, 9-7 is awfully big before you go to South Bend to play the Fighting Irish on Saturday.
It is indeed, but there's a nice job on the entry pass. Nate Robinson trying to rotate over from the weak side, just a little slow getting there. Picks up the foul. That's Nate's 3rd foul, so that's huge. In terms of what Washington wants to do offensively, he carried them for that 4-minute stretch when he scored those 11 points.
Diago drops the free throw. He's now 4 for 5 in the game. And we told you, the average is almost 9 made per contest. Nearing a double-double. He'll be there.
Yet once again. But we talk about Nate Robinson with the 3 fouls. You know, it's big in terms of what he's brought to the table this game, but they've got so many weapons that it's not the end of the world. This man right here, Brandon Roy, a terrific offensive player, when he's called.
Jensen jump hook doesn't go. Kevin Kruger rebounds quickly ahead to Jason Braxton. Dragged his pivot foot as he turned into the face of the defense. Ike doesn't like the call at all.
I thought he should have just went straight left shoulder, drew the contact inside against Mike Gibson, kind of faced up to find him first, and as a result, committed the traveling violation.
Brandon Roy, splendid move. Almost throws it away. Now does, as it's saved by Stevie Moore.
That's good defense. Jason Braxton just kind of reading the eyes of Brandon Roy, much like a defensive back in football. Back to 4 out 1 in. Diago has to hold bottom side to operate. Prepared for Washington. A lot of strong defensive help inside of Diago.
Offensive foul. Diago, his 1st of the game.
He's frustrated. I mean, he didn't want to give the defense a lot of props that first time they met down in Tempe, but this defense is so active inside that I think the thing that separates this Washington defense, the athleticism of these guys, Brandon Roy in this situation, quick enough to get there, put his body right in the path of Diago to pick up the offensive foul.
He was asking Lorenzo Romar how they did it, game one, holding one of the top scorers in the nation to just 14 points, because they are such a smaller team. He just says quickness and strength. Right spot. He can get comfortable. Nate Robin trying to escape, and he gets bumped.
And that defense starts with Mike Jensen, man. That's the strength part. Mike Jensen did a nice job just beating Ike Diago to the spot, beating him to the ball. He's got to come out of the game. We're going to come out of the game at this point. It's up to Hakeem Rollins, but first things first, what do we do offensively? Trey Simmons back on the floor for the Huskies.
Huskies going smaller as it's basically all perimeter players, and Bobby Jones is only 6 feet, 6 inches tall. Hakeem Rollins now checking in the game, a 6'7" senior from Mesa, Arizona. Simmons lit it up early in the first half with three three-pointers. He hits his first three opportunity of the second half.
First things first, let's test that leg out of Trey Simmons. See what it's feeling like. Run some double screen action for him to pop out to that left wing.
Evie Moore misses short. Roy rebounds. He's got Simmons right side. We'll pull it. This is like right.
We'll pull it. I mean, it's like one on four.
But he's got that kind of green light special from his coach Lorenzo Romar, especially coming off of knocking down his prior shot, prior three-pointer. There's Trey in transition right there. Kruger hands down, just kind of not expecting him to pull it from that deep in that situation. Surprise, surprise, surprise.
Washington has their biggest lead of the night, 7 points. The steal by Simmons.
I mean, you know, Arizona State, Steve, is running great offense to get Ike Diago an opportunity to flash from the left box to the right, but the pressure of the Huskies is so intense that Arizona State's not able to make that guard, that simple guard-to-guard pass that would give Ike Diago a chance to receive the basketball. Now what happens, they pull Diago out on the perimeter, a little bit harder to locate defensively for Washington.
Kruger missing, rebounding Rollins, and a foul is called and might be against Angunu. And it will be against Serge Angunu, his third foul of the game.
We expected more from Serge tonight. Again, coming into this game, his last 12 games, he averaged 10 points, 8 rebounds. He struggled his last time out against Oregon, missed 7 out of 8 of his field goal attempts in that game.
Marcus, you know, he is just one season removed from a severe knee injury. Do you believe that maybe this is not a good matchup for him? Because I think defensively he's a little less than. Stevie Moore up. Braxton trying to feed it. Diago gets it back. And will head to the free throw line. Ike Diago with 9 points, 10 rebounds. Our Chevrolet trivia question we asked in the first half. Ike leading the Pac-10, scoring, rebounding. Who is the last Pac-10 player to do it? A.C. Green, a Beaver in 19 and 9 and 84-85.
Alan Morrell going to replace Serge Angunu in the lineup. And again, Morrell did it. Had made his presence felt. When you look at the numbers and you're like, yeah, right. He put up some decent numbers. He had 6 points, a couple of rebounds. I mean, 6 points for Alan Morrell is like tripling his scoring output for the season. So just his presence, he was able to shake things up inside by being physical, being tough, being aggressive in the painted area.
Squares up Braxton, fires it down, got bumped, wanted the foul, doesn't get it. But Washington pushes the lead back to 7.
He is so smooth, Brandon Roy. It's so difficult to defend operating on the elbows because of his ability to get into the middle, spin off a contact, elevate and make shots.
Huskies stay in the man defense. Roy all over Kruger, and a 5-second violation on Arizona State. And the guy leading the charge, Brandon Roy. Offense, defense, he's got it all. Washington by 7 over ASU. Washington has been known to go in those spurts. When you've got a three-point shooter like Trey Simmons, you can rip them off in a hurry.
You got to go in here in the second half. And good job, Lorenzo Lomar, to run some solid offense for him. But this jumper right here, this is all just wala wala. I'm coming down. I'm feeling it. I'm pulling it. And then I'm sticking my tongue out at you on top of that.
He almost shot it from Walla Walla. Well, some Seattle Supersonics interested in this game tonight. There's Reggie Evans on the right, Rashard Lewis on the left. Sonics playing some fine basketball in the NBA and wanting to see some outstanding college hoops over at Bank of America Arena.
I know Rashard does. He never played any, but congratulations to the big guy named to the All-Star team for the first time in his career.
Pretty move by Trey Simmons. He went to the bench with a wounded knee, came out and hits two threes, and now drives to the hoop.
Need to kick him in that knee every time. Just get him out there wounded, dirty, and mad, and angry, and upset, and aggressive. Great defense, half-court defense, once again, by the Huskies, overplaying, hawking, pit bull on a pork chop-style defense.
Ike Diago with another rebound. His 11th. He has 11 points and 11 rebounds. 13 points now and 11 rebounds in the game. But still his team down by 7.
And you're going to give up some of those. You see Ike Diago has inside position because Hakeem Rollins has done a great job defensively fronting as he's been told to do. So you're going to give up some offensive tip jams on occasion because of the solid defense inside.
You've got to explain to our fans pit bull on a pork chop.
They're seeing it. I mean, Arizona State gets the basketball. Nice, nice pick. Rollins.
Moore escaped by, but Will Conroy apparently bumped him. Will Conroy, that might be personal foul number 3 in the game.
Sun Devils hanging around. I mean, you know, the Huskies had better focus and concentrate on trying to extend this lead and put this team away, because this is a team we saw at the end of the first half and to start the game after they got down early. Once they start to reestablish their confidence, especially a man like this Steve Moore, has rarely been heard from tonight. So he's also a potentially explosive scorer that can put some points up quickly.
But Ike is the only man who has been heard from in this half. All 6 Devil points this half and before Steve Moore free throw to cut it to 6. Arizona State, we told you how important the game is as they continue to push the NCAA tournament. They have 18 wins with 3 games to go, including this one. And a tough one at Washington State. And home to number 9, Arizona. Jamal Williams.
Trey, once again. Trey doing a little bit of everything. Jumpers, offensive rebounds, playing tough D at the other end.
Second foul on Allen Morrell. This will send Trey Simmons to the foul line, where he's one of the best in the conference. 86% from the foul line. And this is a young man. You put him with another offense, lesser talent around him, hit average 22, 23 points per game.
He's got that potential. He showed that in junior college, a couple of 50-point games. And you know, with his ability to knock down the long ball, he could get on there and goes. So much balance on this Husky team. 5 players averaging double figures. You don't need that from him.
Moore with the pull-up. Short. Roy has Simmons on the left, spotting up for the 3. Instead, we have a whistle away from the basketball. And I believe the shot clock did not roll. Still on 35. An official's timeout. Well, it says 1:40 remaining in the game, so they got to get the clock straightened out. Both game and shot clock. 11:40.
A guy we haven't seen tonight for Washington, Joel Smith.
Yeah.
He played some pretty good basketball this year. Every time he's put into the game, he's done some things. So that's just for your information. Just thought about that. I saw him out there in warm-ups, and he was active. And he was throwing down and jumping up to the top of the square. So I know he's feeling pretty good.
Well, they're now checking upstairs to find out what the official time is on the clock. I think there should be around 14 minutes left. They had 1:40, now 11:40, and it's going to be right around 14 minutes. 14:04 remaining with 29 seconds left in the shot clock. Well, a foul on Tyrone Jackson, who was fronting Brandon Roy twice tonight. The Sun Devils have been beaten on alley-oop inbounds passes to Brandon Roy catching and either dunking or catching coming down and laying it up and in.
Yeah, I didn't like that foul, coach, just because it's anybody's ball. Once he throws it up there like that, I thought both guys had an opportunity to get that inbounds pass. Flash screen once again.
Simmons once again. Three balls.
Yeah, what is Arizona State going to get hip to that play? I mean, they run that little elbow flare screen. The defender gets caught ball watching, not paying attention to Trey Simmons.
Washington has hit on six straight three-point shots.
Look at the ball pressure. The ball pressure and denial forces Jackson into a timeout situation.
And the Huskies playing like the number 14 team in the nation. They've opened up a 10-point lead on Arizona State. Washington has opened up a 10-point lead on Arizona State.
Now, I said it was a flare screen, but actually Stevie Moore right here just going to lose total sight of Trey Simmons, and no screen is even necessary. He's got to stop the basketball for certain, but also, I mean, you cannot leave the deadly Trey Simmons wide open on his favorite spot.
Now let's have a Corona miles from ordinary. Washington is averaging 86.5 points per game, second to the Tar Heels, 90 per contest. That's the entire season. You look at the Pac-10 conference alone, and it's Arizona number one and Washington number two. Wildcats won tonight, their 24th of the year in overtime over Washington State. Look at the shooting by a half. Washington 63% to Arizona State's 17%.
And again, that's attributable to the Husky defensive ball pressure inside, which has kept Ike Diaga from really getting some quality touches. A lot of his shots have been in offensive rebound putback situations.
Simmons flies down the floor, now drives. And Arizona State will come up with a loose basketball to make a dent after shooting just 17% in the second half.
Too much individual. Like there, Steve Morgan. There's a rebound. Diaga once again gets to the free throw line, but you saw two consecutive possessions. Seen a lot of those possessions with those kinds of shots. Guys are just putting their heads down, getting away from the team concept of what Rob Everton wants to do.
This guy needs to touch the ball more every single offensive possession. 13 points, 12 rebounds. And Ike Diaga was limited to just 14 points in the last meeting against Washington. The result was a 9-point Husky win.
But that's what this Husky defense is designed to do. I mean, you know, Arizona State would love to give him a touch every time down. But because of that pressure, and the pressure's picking him up so high, all of a sudden you feel like, you know, you're not going to be able to make that post feed into Ike, so I need to do something. And as a result, you get Braxton, you get Moore, and you get other guys out there, Jackson, forcing up bad shots. And that's one of the reasons why Arizona State's shooting about 15% for the half.
Arizona State's doing the damage at the line there now. 16 for 20 with someone in the lane.
Yeah, big guy. Small wins.
They've taken 20 foul shots to the Huskies 5. But the Huskies an incredible 10 of 13 from three-point range. Lane violation against Washington gives Diaga another chance. So it's 17 for 20 from the free throw line. And the Sun Devils with an 8. Robinson, Rollins, Roy, Williams, and Simmons in the floor for Washington. It looked like Diago shoved Rollins, but they're saying no advantage gained, so no foul.
Lorenzo Romar complaining about the superstar treatment given to Ike Diago against Hakeem Rollins right there. A lot of arm-to-arm combat going on. There was a little bit of a little bump, a little pushing, a little shoving going on inside. I think the official said, hey, we're going to split the baby. We'll give you the ball back. And we'll call the foul.
So it's Arizona State basketball. The Washington fans do not like the call. And there's someone in maroon in their area, and they want him out. That's why I love college basketball. The students get involved. A packed house here at Bank of America Arena in Seattle, Washington. Alan Morrell strong to the hoop. Can't finish. And that's a tough break right there. That would have been a nice swing for the Sun Devils. A steal by the Sun Devils. Kruger gets it to Braxton. This time the ball will be knocked out of bounds, but the Sun Devils with back-to-back great opportunities, terrific looks at the hoop, and Marcus not taking advantage.
And can't capitalize inside. I mean, Jason Braxton was better to shoot this and try and force this pass inside. Diago gets it there and did a nice job. Brandon Royal with a backflow to keep Ike from getting the easy dunk inside, put him at the free throw line. This game is, again, we've seen a lot of bodies sprawl all over the court, so the officials, you know, are going to keep a close eye on the contact. Here comes that freshman, Joel Smith, that I mentioned earlier.
Host of changes for Washington. Jensen Jones back in with Joel Smith. Robinson and Simmons, Diago at the free throw line.
I mean, it's in some dangerous territory for Washington. This is just a 7-point lead. You see the way these teams have played, the way the Huskies have shot the ball in the second half. The lack of Arizona State being able to knock down shots and stay in this game from the free throw line.
And most of his damage from the line. And Diago now with 17 points, 13 rebounds, but 11 of 12 from the free throw line. He's only taken 8 shots in the game.
Arizona State 3 points down at halftime. They only got one field goal here in the second half. And still only down 6.
Jensen gets hammered by Jason Braxton. And a timeout on the floor with 11:54 remaining in the game. It's the Huskies 58, the Devils 52. Mike Jensen at the free throw line trying to extend the Huskies lead. Arizona State has to feel pretty good being this close. And I say that because they have scored 11 points this half. Only one field goal in almost 8 minutes, or more than 8 minutes. 9 points from the foul line. One field goal. Arizona State. We'll be back at the free throw line again because a foul is called against Washington.
It's Nate Robinson, I thought, going over the back. If it is, it's what, number 4? That's 4 on Nate Robinson.
And they're already in the bonus situation with 11:54 remaining in this game. So Arizona State with a chance to get back in it right now. Tyrone Jackson will be at the free throw line.
Keep chipping away.
Tyrone Jackson
at the line.
Tyrone Jackson, the junior from Fresno Clovis West. He was a junior college All-American at Fresno City College last year. nails the first, will get the second, as it's a 6-point game.
Rob Evans loves to go that junior college route. Take a look at Nate Robinson. He's got to be frustrated. Got himself a seat on the pine with that gamble over the top of the missed free throw. Curtis Millage, Jamal Hill, all JC guys for Rob Evans. Some hand out better than others. It's always a crapshoot. It's a very different level of intensity and speed of game.
Simmons missing. Diago rebounds, his 14th board of the night.
The Huskies had a chance to put this Arizona State team away, even though, you know, they would say, well, we would have put them away, but the refs kept them in the game.
Jackson fires it down from the right wing, and it's a 3-point game.
Now you got some confidence. So the Arizona State team will bench up, cheering. They're fired up. They feel like they can win this thing.
Simmons had it partially blocked. Let's go to our Subway hot shot of the game, and let's go to the man, Tyrone Jackson from Fresno.
You're going to see baseline wide open. Jensen Conroy just a little slow reacting. Tyrone Jackson says, yeah, I got some ups. Throws it down inside.
Arizona State on an 8-1 run to close within three. Now Simmons back to the free throw line, an 86% foul shooter. Lorenzo Romar knows the story. He has to win to keep pace with Arizona. They were a game and a half back when the game started. Arizona won their game in overtime in Pullman against the Cougars. And now Washington trying to win before Arizona arrives on Saturday for a 1 o'clock game here on FSN.
Huskies fall back into that 2-3 zone that proved to be effective in the first half, mainly because Rob Evans took Ike Diago from the post to put him out on the perimeter. Now he sticks it back down in that post. I much prefer to see him down there because he's an offensive rebound.
Alan Morrell missing. Braxton wins it and scores from the right side.
And Diago all in the mix right there. Offensive glass in the paint doing some work.
If they stay in that zone, let's see if they bring Stevie Moore back in the game to get some free shooting strength. Jensen.
Jensen showing some footwork of his own. I thought the principle of verticality should have been in play. A little bit of a scrum underneath. Alan Morrow going to shoot the fadeaway. And ball kind of batted around. Watch Diago get on the floor right in there. Just kind of keep it alive. Braxton picks up the loose change and finishes off the play.
Jensen now 1 of 3 from the free throw line. And as a team, they've made 7 of 10. While Arizona State's doing their damage coming back in this game from the foul line, 21 of 24, and Stevie Moore will now come back in the game. Braxton leaves. Braxton not a good outside shooter, and dropping to the 2-3 zone, Moore becomes the value player, and Stevie will go move to the spot, and Kevin Kruger or Tyrone Jackson will take over the point. They'll split the floor with the wings being Kruger right, Moore left.
I'm surprised we haven't seen a little more Bryson Kruger also against his zone defense. I love the job Steve Moore has done.
We haven't even seen Bryson Kruger in the game.
Well, he started the game off, and but Moore's played decently. Hasn't really kind of set the world on fire.
They're trying to fire a pass through the defense and find Ike Diago instead. It winds up in a Husky's hand, and a foul will be called on Tyrone Jackson. This is a time where Jackson has to play smart basketball for Rob Evans. Evans has taken out his starting point guard, has made 97 starts in the past for ASU. And Jackson has to give Evans a reason to leave him on the floor. Them both.
Uh-oh.
And Jensen was in the lane too early. And that's the second time Washington has been hurt with a lane violation. Poise of Romar, he's not getting upset. Can't control that. get back, play defense.
Well, he's upset. He's just not letting us see it.
Exactly.
Or his team see it. I mean, trust me, he's upset. But he did a great job of maintaining.
It's a gel yourself moment. Just reach in your pocket and take a gel yourself.
And once again, the little four out one hand trying to work Ike Diago down low against his own.
Oh, that's a bad shot by Jackson. He took a shot about 26 feet from the hoop, and he's bailed out because of a foul call against the Washington Huskies, Jamal Williams.
And Rob Evans trying to get his attention to let him know about that bad shot. Finally does. But, you know, I mean, in Jackson, I like what he brings to the table. He's a real tough defensive player. You saw his athleticism and that blow-by dunk going right. But, you know, I think also a good team for Rob Evans against this zone. Also, the two Kruger guys, Kevin Kruger does a pretty good job of running the point.
Marcus, what a difference a game makes. Ike Diago only one foul shot in their loss to the Huskies in Tempe. He has 13 and has made 12 tonight.
And that's the benefit of having Ike Diago. I mean, not only does he get to the line, but he's just such a great free throw shooter. It's all gravy. And to get there 15 times and then maybe like Shaq make about 6 or 7. He gets there 15, he's making 13 or 14.
Williams fouled as he tried to jump hook. That's against Jackson. That's 2 in the last minute. It is against Tyrone Jackson, his 4th personal foul. So this causes some headaches for Rob Evans because he's got to get Jason Braxton back in the game. And if Washington goes with a 2-3 zone, he almost becomes ineffective.
Yeah, you give Jason Braxton all kinds of room out there at the top of that zone to pull a 20-footer anytime he wants to. And the strength of his game, Braxton, is to try and penetrate, but obviously against that zone, not a whole lot of lanes to the basket available.
Jamal Williams makes one of 2 foul shots. Huskies by 4, 9.5 left. Braxton at the point.
Which again makes me wonder what's going on with Bryson Kruger. See the 2-3 zone once again. And like Diago, the defense magnet. Kevin Kruger should have shot that if he had it on a string. He pulled it back and threw that up there with the whistle blew. But still, they're in the bonus, so they put it somewhat loose.
And an outstanding foul shooter, and Kevin Kruger will be at the foul line. The son of Lon Kruger is the head coach at UNLV. And I had a chance to watch his father win 2 Big 8 MVP awards years ago for the Kansas State Wildcats. Pop now, the head coach of the Running Rebels. That's the 36th foul whistle tonight. There's Bryson Kruger, a 49% three-point shooter. Right now, just with his jersey on.
There's something about the whistle of the official. I think. Take his whistle, okay. Nice clean protest. I can buy that.
Take his whistle. All 3 officials still have their whistles, and we continue. It's a tough job. 64-62. Huskies by 2 over the Sun Devils.
Half the people are going to be mad at you.
Simmons, where has he been? He's got 25. Quiet for a while after a flash of 10 points in a 5-minute period of the second half.
Yeah. Once again, solving the zone defense of the Huskies is going to be the major nut to crack for Arizona State.
It's amazing the Huskies only lead by 5 and have made 11 of 14 three-point shots. Stevie Moore, long. Morrell gets it back.
Stevie Moore, one of those kinds of guys that are.
Kruger had to take the shot. The shot clock was down to 2 and hits one from about 28 feet out. You know what? I think Rob Evans likes that kid's moxie.
He's a shooter. He's got that mentality.
But he also has an understanding and awareness of how much time was left. Inside. Jamal Williams.
He's got his good point also, Jamal Williams. I mean, he can get you some points. I mean, his whole purpose of being in the game, being on the floor, is to score points.
Huskies stay in the 2-3 zone. Simmons, Conroy out top. They get it to Diago. And Ike nails just his fourth field goal of the game. He now has 21 points to go with his 14 rebounds.
Starting to see the outside shooting from both teams starting to heat up again. A little fade moves Trey Simmons. Kevin Kruger, awareness of the shot clock, just kind of shot, puts it up there. And then from Alan Morrow, Ike Diago. Nice job with the medium range. Yaka.
Our Jack in the Box game summary. Trey Simmons, who had been cool the last four games, erupting for 17 of his 25 in the second half. Ike Diago, 21 and 14, most of the damage done at the line. And look at the three-point shooting, 11 of 14 for the Huskies, but they only lead by two. Simmons, 25 points, 8 of 17 floor, 6 of 7 from three-point range. The Huskies' all-time record for most threes in a game is 7, set by Sen Kukere and Deion Lewis. Trey Simmons now with 26 points. We had that game against Oregon where he was 1 for 11 and the Huskies won in overtime.
Thanks. A major part to Will Conroy. Bobby Jones stepped into the breach and picked up some of the scoring slack. Nate Robinson had a huge game for him that evening. And once again, until they saw this 2-3 zone, Arizona State's going to see a whole lot more of it here in the second half.
Well, spinning inside, looking to Williams. This is the shot. Bobby Jones rebounds.
And if you're Washington, you love Alan Morrell to start thinking like he's got to be the guy to score some points.
And it's off Williams out of bounds. Conroy had the edge, fed his man on the low block. Off Williams, hands out of bounds. It's ASU basketball with just inside 7 minutes left. Huskies came in with 21 wins.
This thing is, yeah. I mean, just so up for grabs. I mean, I don't know if the fans, you look at the score and you see it, but because you shot the ball so well, you don't really, I think, have an idea just how close this thing is to being a demoralizing defeat here at home at Bank of America. We're winning, won 13 in a row, 20 in a row in the last couple of years.
Kruger misses the three. Conroy has Simmons off in the right, drives the bucket and scores.
That's the Will Conroy we saw up in Eugene. You know, once his team needed some scoring, he provided some scoring. And right there, just a coast-to-coast foray down the teeth of the defense. Like a Bryson Kruger in place of a Braxton to catch that draw and kick at the top of the key.
Moore missing, Morrell missing, Conroy rebounds, a 3-on-2 break. Will giving up to Williams.
Yeah, we got two different. He had one outside official signal a charge.
And Tim Gavagallo underneath called a blocking foul.
It's a tough, tough call, block, charge. Such a bang, bang play right here. Moore, pretty good position. He was kind of leaning. I can see why the baseline official called the block, because he probably saw more of a lean than the outside guy. That's why it's such a tough call.
So the officials will get together, Kevin Brill, Tim Gavitaro, and Bill Kennedy.
Yeah, I mean, I saw two different calls on the same play. I mean, we showed the replay. I still saw two different calls.
Yeah.
mean, is Stevie Moore set? You know, is he set or is he moving after Williams leaves the air? I mean, he looks pretty set to me.
I think it's a charge.
Yeah, from that angle, he looks pretty set. You see the outside official, Bill Kennedy, giving the charge signal. To get together, they got to defer to who had the better angle, who saw it, who had the clearest vantage point of looking at the play. Steve Moore can't believe it. Looked like he was in pretty good position.
Jamal Williams will be at the foul line, a 58% foul shooter. The Huskies up by 6 over Arizona State. One for Jamal Williams. Washington's biggest lead has been 10 points. It is now a 7-point edge. Nate Robinson will come back in the game playing with 4 fouls. Rollins has 3 fouls, Williams with 3 fouls. Two players on Arizona State have 4. Jason Braxton, who's on the floor with 4, and Tyrone Jackson with 4.
Once again, Lorenzo Romar's got a quick defensive unit on the floor, but he's staying in the zone as a protective measure. Gonna protect his little guy, Nate Robinson, and some of these other guys in foul trouble.
Diago hits a second field goal in the last minute. He now has 23 points.
That's where he's improved his game a lot. That little medium range face-up jumper with the little fade to create some space on the baseline.
Robinson looking for the screen from Jensen. Nate Robinson, what a play. He's been so quiet in the second half because of the foul difficulty. Diago getting it back, scoring right over Trey Simmons.
Great secondary sideline break, which gives Diago the whole interior area of the basket to get his man on his back to steal, get a pass delivered inside.
Bobby Jones, Jensen grabbed the rim on to try to tap it in. It goes to Arizona State with 4:53 left. Nate with his first field goal in the second half right here.
All strength right here. Going to get Braxton right on that shoulder, bounce him back a bit, create some space, and then sideline break up the sideline. Cooper's got it. Once again, Jensen with the dribble, getting himself out of position. That's about as easy a two as Ike Diago's been able to generate all night.
Diago stays on the floor only with 2 fouls. Braxton at the point. Moore and Kruger are the 3 shooters. Braxton, nice drive. He's having him one of his better games. Now, all of it have been on drives inside, but Jason Braxton, 5 of 6, throwing for 10 points. Robinson short, Morrell rebound.
It was too easy that last drive. Now, Jason Braxton, you know that's the strength of his game. Give him a cushion, make him have to shoot an outside shot at the very least, but don't give him a lane to the basket.
Setting up for the 3. They work it inside Diago. Diago has the edge on Jensen. And it's won by Trey Simmons, a 3-on-2 break. Conroy right back to Simmons for 2. 7 assists for Will Conroy, the Pac-10 leader.
Once again, a gambling defender gets himself out of position. That time, Jason Braxton. You're going to go for that steal. You better be sure you can get it because you give up easy twos. Oh! Off comes the coat. Can't believe that foul called on Bobby Jones. Looks like he got all ball right on top of that shot by Diago.
Conroy to Simmons, tying a career high with 29 points. but we were asking the question earlier, how strong a team is Washington? Are they a two seed this year? Their RPI ranking is 8, strength of schedule 26. Look at their good wins. I mean, they're one of the only teams in college basketball who has beaten the leader of the Mountain West Conference in Utah, and they beat powers of the Big 12, SEC, and ACC.
And you lose to UCLA at Pauley Pavilion. They lose to Oregon State, a team that's been very tough to beat in Corvallis. To lose it to them at home, those are not bad losses in my mind.
They are bad losses when you lead UCLA by 18.
Well, now you want to nitpick and pick the game possession by possession. I'm just saying overall, I mean, it was a bad loss.
Ike Diago, meantime, 12 of 12 from the free throw line in the second half. But they've beaten teams like Utah, Oklahoma, Alabama, North Carolina State. Their RPI is strong. I think they are a two seed, but they must take care of business. And business tonight is with Arizona State. Bobby Jones with a great follow.
One thing that the selection committee talks about is taking each game individually. So this game will be looked at on its own merits also for Washington. I think they may be looking past Arizona State. I mean, it's human nature.
We're here in Washington. The Washington Huskies, the number 14 team in the nation, and the Arizona State Sun Devils trying to get to the NCAA tournament, coming in with 18 wins. But here at Bank of America, the University of Washington has not lost at home this year. A perfect 13-0 record. Steve Fisiak, Marcus Johnson with you. Pac-10 basketball on FSN. Diago on the floor with Morrell Moore. Kevin Kruger, 4-3.
Coach's kid, KK out there, Kevin Kruger. Again, you know he's the most dangerous shooter on the floor. You've got to play tag with him, stay within arm's length.
5 of 8 from three-point range, now 17 points for the coach's son.
That's great. He didn't need a whole lot of room to get that.
Oh, look at Nate Robinson sneaking inside to score.
A little do-si-do move on the blockout attempt.
Jackson back in, playing with 4 fouls. Morrell, big rebound. Yeah. Kruger misses this time from 3 range, and Simmons goes out of bounds with the basketball. It's ASU ball with 1:56 left and down by 5.
Husky fans thought they saw a mugging going on in the corner. But Steve Moore going after the basketball along with Trey Simmons.
Richard Romar trying to get Hakeem Rollins in the game for Mike Jensen. ASU basketball down 5. Washington against Arizona State. There is the turnover. And that's what cost the Sun Devils in their 9-point loss to Washington in Tempe. They had 10 more turnovers. Well, in this ball game, they have 15. And Washington has one more with 16. There's a ball that is thrown away, and that's 17 turnovers by Washington. Diago inside Morrell. Jackson says, let's slow things down. They've got a mismatch here with speed. They've got Diago inside, and he is fouled, and Ike will be back at the free throw line where he is 15 for 16 from the foul stripe in this game.
That's what you want to do. I mean, you want to do that all along, but especially here down the stretch with Washington in the bonus with Diago's ability to knock down free throws with his wide base and setup ability to make himself a big target inside.
.28 for Ike Diago. 6 of 12 floor, 15-16 line.
Has not been an easy 28.
With those two 17 out of 18 from the line.
Wow, that's incredible. That's the kind of stroke that he has from the line. And Roma, I want to talk things over, make sure he gets a good quality shot on this possession.
Because his Huskies have a three-point lead with 1:15 left in the game. Our Pontiac game-changing performance. How about Trey Simmons, 6 of 7 from three-point range.
Fade corner, Trey Simmons getting out in transition. This is the one Kevin Cooper didn't think he was gonna pull it up that deep, but he's got that kind of range, that kind of green light. It's just a bad job defensively. Once a guy gets hot, not tracking him, making sure you're aware of where he is at all times. Braxton with the gamble, with out of position. Leads to the easy two inside, but Trey's been doing pretty much a little bit of everything out on the floor.
And there's that Bane press. Trey Simmons with 29 points, 6 of 7 floor. Pontiac will donate $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of Washington for today's Pontiac game-changing performance. Lorenzo Romar with Ken Bone, Cameron Dollar, and Jim Shaw. Mike Diago, they're trying to find a way to solve him, but right now offensively, Washington has the ball with 75 seconds left in a three-point lead.
Obviously, Arizona State just need the foul here if you can avoid it. Just a solid defensive possession. But so many weapons for the Huskies. Where do you go? Trey Simmons with the big night. Dave Robertson always dangerous with his ability to put it on the floor.
Braxton on Robinson.
That will kind of give him some space and allow him to create.
Down to 5. Here goes Robinson. What a shot by Nate the Great.
He's got this terrific ability to gather himself in the middle of a full-blown spin, a full-blown pirouette. It's almost like he slows down in midair, locates, and finishes off the play. Just remarkable. Man, you're thinking he's out of control here on the spin. All of a sudden, just kind of slows it down. Finds exactly what spot he wants to put the ball in on the bank angle, and then executes the shot. I mean, he does that as well as anybody I've seen in a long time.
Well, around the Pac-10 with 2 weeks to go, every game awfully important, and Arizona by 1 over Washington State in overtime. Oregon State sneaks by Stanford. Now you've got a jockey position for 3 and 4 with Stanford and UCLA. Oregon beat California 63-58, and UCLA, well, they hammered USC 90-69. So right now UCLA has a 9-7 record, and Stanford is 9-6 with just a half game lead. Our standings. There they are. Arizona a full 2 games in front of Washington, so the Huskies need to win to stay within a game and a half of the front-running Wildcats. Stanford at 9-6. UCLA should be 9-7. UCLA just a half game back at 9-7. And Arizona State, of course, they need to win one of the next 3 to really help themselves out for the NCAA tournament committee. They are in Pullman on Saturday and then close their season hosting the number 1 team in the conference, the Arizona Wildcats. Here we go. Moore, Morrell, Jackson, Diago, Kruger. Washington moves to a man defense. Jackson slides in, misses the shot, and a foul is called.
On Tyrone Jackson, offensive foul called, out of control. Total unawareness of the situation. I mean, he knew that they needed to score opposite in that situation, but he just over-penetrated, kept coming. Very easy play for the defender, very easy call for the official to make.
What's wrong with getting the ball to Diago, who's 17 for 18 from the foul line?
Just giving it up in general. I mean, he just put his head down, had his mind made up exactly what he was going to try and do.
And how about the team style defense by Bobby Jones? The third time he's accepted a charge in this game. A foul called on Kevin Kruger that will send Will Conroy to the free throw line. 26.5 seconds left. Jackson fouling out. 7 assists for Will Conroy, who's been the Pac-10 leader.
He needed 8 coming into this game. A single season. Chester Dorsey.
Well, he could get it tonight. We may see him get it on Saturday, and a great showcase that everybody in Seattle has been waiting for. Huskies hosting the Wildcats of Arizona. Conroy makes them both. Moore tied up. Great defense. Stevie just throws it up wildly. Diago catches, lays it in, and Robinson will let them foul him. Well, Washington, with a courageous effort. It's not too many times that you lose games where you shoot 69% from 3-point range, and it doesn't look like Lorenzo Romar's team will lose, as his Huskies went 11 of 16 from 3-point range. 33 points from 3-point range.
And the reemergence offensively of Trey Simmons. That's a great deal going into this Arizona game coming up Saturday. Trade and break out of that slump. I mean, the last few games he's been shooting the ball terribly.
He went through a stretch where he made just 3 of 25, but then in the second half against Washington State made his last 3 and opened by hitting his first 2 of this one, and has made 6 of 7 for 29 points. That's a game high, and also a steal by Robinson, and a jam. And Washington off for their 22nd win of the year. We're all set up for Saturday. Lorenzo Romar and the Huskies will be hosting Lute Olson and the Wildcats. Cats with a game and a half lead. Welcome to Romarville. And Bank of America, 14 for 14 this year. That's it from Seattle, 90 to 82. For Marcus Johnson, I'm Steve Piziak saying so long, everyone.